In this video, we'll be installing SQL Server 2012 Express as part of our Pi Server installation or upgrade. As of Pi Data Archive 2010, installing the Pi Data Archive requires an AF server on the network, and in order to install an AF server, you'll need a SQL Server to host its AF database. So whether you're installing a new Pi Data Archive or upgrading your data archive from a version older than 2010, installing a new SQL Server will be your first step. If you already have a SQL Server that you intend to use, make sure you find out what its hostname is, and then continue on with the next video. So the first thing we'll do is open the white paper we downloaded in the last video to make sure our system meets all the requirements to install a SQL Server. So here in the Install SQL Server 2012 Express Prerequisites section, we'll see that we need Microsoft .NET Framework 3.5, Microsoft .NET Framework 4, and Windows PowerShell 2.0. So here in our Server Manager, we will manage our roles and features. And now after selecting our server and editing the features, we don't yet have .NET Framework 3.5 installed, but we do have .NET Framework 4.5 installed, which will cover our 4.0 requirement. We also have Windows PowerShell 4.0 installed, which will cover our Windows PowerShell 2.0 requirement. So we'll carry on by selecting our .NET Framework 3.5 feature and clicking Next. Now we're met by a warning saying we might need to specify an alternate source path to install .NET Framework 3.5. This is because Windows Server 2012 by default might not necessarily have all the installation files necessary to install .NET Framework 3.5. Microsoft has published a KB on this issue, so by searching for Microsoft KB 2734782, we'll be provided with multiple different ways to solve this issue. We'll be choosing method 4, which involves downloading the installation files ourselves and then specifying the source path to those installation files in the Add Roles and Features wizard. I have them here in my Pi install folder on my C drive. So what I'll do is I'll copy this file path here and paste it in the wizard in the specify an alternate source path here. This is the method that worked the best for me, but make sure you read the article and choose the one that works for you. Now I'll click Install. Now that our feature's installed, we'll go ahead and run our install kit. But first, we will check to make sure that we're a local administrator on the computer. So here in Tools, Computer Management, we'll look at our local users and groups and make sure that we're in the administrators group. And here I can see my personal account, so we should have no problem running the install kit. So we'll right-click and run it as administrator. So we will install a new SQL Server standalone. So we'll accept the license terms. And now the installer is going to check to see if there's any updates that it can find. So it's discovered a product update, so we'll go ahead and install that. So we'll keep the default features selected and see that we have all of the prerequisites already installed or will be installed. So we'll click Next. And here's where we can name the instance of our SQL Server. This default is what we'll use, so we'll click Next again. And it's in our best practices to run the SQL database engine as a relatively low privileged account. So this network service is going to work. I'll leave the server browser disabled because it's unnecessary for SQL databases to function when they're on the same machine as the AF server. We'll click Next here. Now I'll specify the SQL Server administrators. I do want to be an administrator, but rather than add my account specifically, what I'll do is I'll add the local administrators group. And because I am a local administrator, I will get SQL administration by default. So we'll select the computer and then type in administrators. And remove my personal account. Remember, I'm still going to get administrator because I'm part of this group. We'll leave data directories default to install all the binaries on the C drive, but we'll uncheck that users are allowed to run a separate instance of the database engine. We'll also leave FileStream turned off. And I'll choose to send Windows and SQL Server error reports. From this screen, we can see that the SQL Server is installed successfully, so we should have no problems installing the AF server. In the next video, we'll finish off the installation with the Py server by installing the AF server and then the Py data archive, as well as performing some best practices configuration that's always important to do on a freshly installed Py server.